I'm sitting here talking, my mic is muted. So, anyway, as I was saying, trying to figure out the diorama side of things here and the layout for the troops. And initially, I was going to use these guys, the expansion set with the heavy weapon guys. Because it just seemed like it was the most logical kind of a thing. But I'm not really sure. Where I want them to go, really. And I also have the regular troopers here. I feel like the regular troopers would be better. But I want the guy. I wish the guy with the T-21 had a more exciting pose. Can I switch guys? Can I switch this to a different unit guy? I don't know. Let's see. No, nope, that's the guy I just had it on. Let's try this guy. No, it doesn't look like it. It's not going in that one. Pretty sure that T21 guy. Sudden, let's not glued in. Okay, there we go. Like walking through the jungle. Okay. There we go. Okay, perfect. So this guy will be my T21 guy. It's like, do, getting ready to shoot some rancors. Okay, so where's the rest of my weapons? Oh, right here. Okay, that's guy. I'll just. He'll be a. Just his regular officer. With a. Oh, looking at the wrong post. So I want to put. I think a tree stump like right here. A tree stump here. Okay, there's a tree stump with a broken tree. Okay, right. Whatever. The broken log across here. Or maybe just fallen into the water. And then Rancor's pretty grumpy. Because he's just been in a cage. The cage is going to be kind of stuck in like that, though. So. It'll be dug in for sure, because it'll have fallen out of a. Out of a transport. This won't be very deep, it'll probably be up to their knees. So to try and figure out how to pour the resin and leave a circle thing so I can slide this guy in. Okay, I guess the next big thing is taking and cutting my terrain. I still don't know which guys to use. I need to start putting these together. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. I was thinking about like having them trudge through the river. Could probably, I don't know, but okay. These guys are going to be moving forward. So this guy here, this guy. Where's my other trooper? What do I have? Five? I have five? So five. All right, I gotta take one of these. Wait, let's take. He's gonna be running up. This guy's gonna be running up. That guy over there. Just take that. Actually, let's do this. Let's move. The one dude behind the log there. This guy's running. No. I don't know what I'm doing here. I don't know what I'm doing here. Alright, this guy, I want him there. That's for sure. That guy can stand there, I guess. 21 guy running. And then I thought I had another heavy weapons guy, because he's missing some arms. Unless he's just a blaster dude. He must just be blaster dude. Oh, wait a minute. One of these guys carries... Where's... Ah, there it is. So I got like a concussion pack. There we go. It doesn't fit on this guy though. Concussion pack must go on this guy. Oh, I actually got those. Is that a concussion pack or is it binoculars? Okay, that's not that guy then. That's gonna be this for sure. So it's a funny socket in there, okay. So, maybe this guy? Let me take this off. I should probably just go and look at the box. There we go. Yeah, it's gonna be that guy. And then... where's the... Okay, so what does he have in his hand then? If he's carrying that... my hand's blown off. Okay. It's probably this guy then. No, that's not the right arm. This arm. Yeah, I'm ready to shoot some things. Pew, pew, pew. Alright. Then this. Nope, not that. Ah, I'm dropping stuff. Okay. This guy, maybe. Okay, there's that. And I need an arm next. They're kind of tricky to line up. Which one is which? Is the question. Okay. Yep, there we go. Blaster guy. You can follow up in the water, and this guy will be like, bring up the heavy weapons. Bring up the heavy weapons. Yeah, this guy here. Bring it. Okay. Alright, I Not sure where I'm going to place the guys, but I think that's a good layout for where I want them to be in the diorama anyway. And try to make and avoid the edges. Of course, this is all sloped inwards and that kind of thing, so. Is it going to be in water as well? Okay. Alright, so. What do I want to do next? I'll probably put some rocks here. Maybe some broken concrete rocks? Broken concrete or just rocks? Maybe more debris. That would be better. Like other debris that's kind of fallen out of So some crates. Smaller crates. Kind of floating in the water. Scattered about. Along with the Rancor. Yeah, so this will be here. We'll put some more crates like on the bank here and here, here and here. Yeah, I think that'll be good. A door broke there like that. Door broke there like that. Off kilter. Okay. It should fit nicely on a shelf too. Once it's all said and done. But that's the easy part, isn't it? Okay. Oh, hang on. I'll draw circles here. And so this is a rough outline where I want things to be. I want some cattails or something like that growing up out of these, probably over here, because this will be an effluent kind of thing. It's going to be murky, cruddy water. Okay. Close this. Okay. Get myself styrofoam. Go and draw this onto the styrofoam, I guess. I have to cut out this piece of styrofoam because it's a huge piece, so I will be right back. Okay, so I've got the foam back. I tried my hot wire cutters that I got, and looks like it's a bit stringy on this stuff. I'm just gonna pull these strings off and throw them away. Definitely gonna have to sand the sides, I think, but I'm not gonna do that right now. I'm gonna work more on the layout part again. Just take some of this stuff. Is it gone there? Okay. Okay. So, where did I put my paper layout drawing? Just set it down. Where'd it go? I'm gonna cheat with this stuff. I'm gonna 3D print some of these crates. Find some Star Wars reference crates online and actually print them in place. Okay. Now then, I just put my Sharpie down. I gotta get back up again. Okay. Let me see here. Yeah, I think a hot wire cutter table may be in order if this continues, and I'll do well with it. I do have the drop pod diorama that I've been trying to do as well, but nothing special here. It's this side, right? Okay. Now then, could use my blowtorch and blowtorch this. Try that. Let's see how that works. Or I just dig it out. Let me do this first. Because this I need to get painting. So I need to, let's draw around the back side here like this. Rough outline of where the box is going to be. And rancor. So I'll need to dig down around this base. So I'll be covering the base that he's on. Which I probably could just use sculpt a mold or whatever, which is pretty certain that's what will be also used to help with all of that. Okay. So that's that. So I want to get an angle here. I don't know where to start. The front bit's gonna be sticking. Let's take out little bits at a time. Actually, I may end up probably take longer, but I'm gonna actually just use this for the base, the bottom of the water. Okay. Keep these bits for use later. There. Can I do this? I'm gonna have to rotate this big thing, I think. Get a better angle. I could probably use this as a debris that around this from falling out of the starport or falling out of the transport that is okay. getting there. Let's see. Fit test. Yeah, okay. That's kind of good there. Because again, this is going to have... Let's go a little bit deeper, I think. I'll be careful here, I'm gonna slice myself. Let's do this under here. There we go. Okay, I think it needs to be a little bit more dug out there. So it needs to go a little deeper. Let's just get that. Perfect. That's going to be nice. I'll give it the right angle that I want. And I guess I could use the hot wire cutter at the right angle here, but this is fun. To make little bits of styrofoam come out, which I can use later on, either in this project or other projects. probably use some of the mangled bits for the whatchamacallit, the base of the bottom of the river, which I think I am gonna try and use my torch for, but I'm not gonna do that on camera because I need to take it outside. Cleaner cut. Yep. Yep. Okay. There we go. That there like that. Okay, and then I'm going to go down like this. And then cut across this way. Lengthen it a little bit here. There we go. All right, now let's see what this looks like in there. Much better fit. That's gonna be pretty much perfect for what I need it to be. Okay, there's that. Now let's see. Rancor doesn't have to be dug out that deeply, though, but... Okay. Alright, be right back. I'm gonna try and do this bit. Probably use a test piece first. And Alright, so that worked reasonably well. I mean, that gave me the texture at the bottom, but I think I do need to cut it out more. I think that'll help me. Then I'll just use the other thing again to. Let's use the hot wire cutter here. Get some more depth on this. Let's see if I can do this on camera as well. Where can I plug it in at? Where can I plug it in at? No lights. There we go. Lit up here. Let's see how this goes. This out of the way. I got my fan on, my stuff, so this should be okay. Are we hot yet? We're getting there. Just a little bit on the slow side. All right. Starting over on this edge here. I don't know, I feel like there's something to be said about. Using a proper cutter. Blade, I mean. Alright, that's a bit deeper. Let me see, where's this stormtrooper for size? Yeah, it's probably good there. I mean, feel like this could get a little hotter. It might be, feels like it's a little harder to pull this stuff through the foam than I expected. So when I do the other part of the diorama, I just need to do the effluent pipe on this end here. It's all stringy. It's stringy bits of string. Okay, there's some strange pieces here now. All right, let's do the same thing on this side. you go. Maybe it just needs to heat up. I don't know. Burning some styrofoam today. And I'll go over it with the hot, the torch thingy and okay, there's that. Let's pull that out. Ooh. Go to a little bit more depth. Let's go this way. Okay, and then I'm just gonna try and make it a little deeper in the middle now with some different cuts here and there. There's that. Whoa. I wonder what the best way to clean these things is. I'm sure there's a way to clean these. Oh, I still have my Be Right Back up. I'm still streaming. And that's there. Okay, stop. Give me my mouse. And I'm... Alright, time to burn more styrofoam. Definitely want it deeper than this. Resin pour will go into this at some point. This will be my first foray into resin, so I'll probably cock that up somehow. This way. Okay. So much string. Ooh. It's actually hardened the outside quite a bit and making it harder to cut away. There we go. Get that off there. Ah, I could probably be using this way around now. Don't know about that. I think I need to tighten it down. Can't do that right yet. Let's rotate it here, get a better angle. Burning plastic. Well, it's a good thing I've got fans going and the window open. Okay, there's that. Take this ridge off. Ooh. Oh crap. There we go. Okay. Yep, okay. And this bit here is next. I'll probably do another stream tomorrow, same time. Sure how long this one's been going, about an hour and a half. Okay. I've really got to start painting the stormtroopers and gluing them together, but I am so afraid to do that and have them look like crap when they come out and have this really nice looking diorama but with crappy painted stormtroopers. Okay, this will be the last one, and then this. I'm gonna get turned off. I'm gonna run downstairs and. Let's let that cool for a minute. Okay. Yep. Rancor buddy goes there. Thing goes there. Door goes behind Rancor. stormtroopers. Where's my stormtroopers? Stormtrooper dude here. Ready to shoot them. This would be cool. Question is, should I? I think I need to cut that out a little bit. I think I need to cut that. I can't. I don't want to use this cutter on it. I need to cut it. Is this cooled down now? Yes, okay. Let's put this away and unplug it. Move the styrofoam bits away. Man, that adapter's hot as heck. Pet the doggy. Let me go spray this. I will be back again momentarily. Okay, I should have probably cut some of this down with the hobby knife, to be honest, rather than doing what I just did. Let's see here. I'm gonna need to sand the edge on the back sides. But I think I want to paint now. Not this piece. I just wanted to get the layout going. How many stormtroopers am I putting on this thing? Alright, not the ones in the bags. Unless anyone has a recommendation, I'm going to use these guys. That's not his. I don't think we got in the bag. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here. 4 of them. Okay, 5 of them. I need to get some twigs outside for the tree. How thick do I want the tree? And then the dude's base is gonna... One of these guys is gonna be in the water, so I'll probably have to build that up. I'll cut it out again. Yeah, this is going to be tricky trying to get the bases in here. I'm not sure how to do that. Okay. T21 at the front. That guy, I want him like right there. Concussion guy can go back here. That dude there. Officer there. Okay. I feel like until I get a little bit more terrainy texture on here, I wonder how difficult it is to cut sculpta mode. I guess I could test it. All right, let's take these guys off here. That can go there. I'm gonna cut out. Where's my cut? Cut this out a little bit. Not too deep. Not too deep. I don't need it that deep. That's probably good. I didn't know styrofoam had a grain to it. It's trouble with some of these. Yeah, apparently it does. You can see the striped lines here. Turn it around here. Get a better angle. Okay. see here. Move that guy out of the way because this is getting tricky now. Okay, like that. Yep. Okay. Okay, I think I got it there. All right, so let's go start cutting straight lines, I guess. Ugh. Come on, there we go. Should be easiest to pick out. Because if I go a bit too deep, I can always build it back up again. Straight line, because the straight lines are a pain in my neck. Okay. Yep, there we go. Okay. Offers me better control than using the hot wire cutter right now. I'm gonna have to work with that a little bit longer, and it's not getting as hot as I would have expected it to or would have liked it to, but it's doing the task for what I need. So I guess the next bit is to try and lift some of these out. Can I do this? Where's my spatula thingy? Let's try that. Okay. Just cut it out like this, I guess. Again, sculpt a mold will be my friend. Not that I have to use that, but I'll probably figure out something. I'm getting close to the time period where I need to really focus on the diorama techniques now that this is taking shape. This is an awkward angle right here. If there was a tool that was flat like this, but serrated, that would probably be a lot easier than picking this stuff out. I guess I could have cut the base off of the Rancor. But I really wasn't sure what I was doing with the Rancor until much later. Okay. This is gonna take forever to do this. I'm getting somewhere, I guess. Good. Okay. All the bone bits everywhere. There we go. Doing these things is going to be tricky as well. Let's just see if there's anything online where somebody's done that same thing. I don't know. Could use some hints. Hey, thanks for the sub. Renato, I think that's just how you pronounce it. Okay, there's that. Okay. Come on, I want to get the painting. Or at least base coat this Rancor cage and figure out how I want to paint this thing. Too deep because the base is going to be covered by stuff anyway. I just need a little bit more recessed, I think. Perfect. He fits. Yep, that's better.
Much better.
Let's see if we can see that on the cameras. Do-do-do. Okay, so that's that. I need a box for my plastic bits. They're not plastic bits, the foam. Okay, just take a minute here for thinking. So the next steps, probably different stream. Need to sand the sides. I may actually just do that off camera and just post it to Instagram because that's going to be a little on the messy side. Sand the sides, smooth out the edge. Let's see, can I get on camera? Smooth out this edge here because it's terrible. That side's good. This side is good. And then do I sculpt and mold it first, then paint it, or do I paint it, then sculpt and mold it? That is the question. I need to make a list of what I need to do. I'm going to lose track of what I need to do. Alright, let's switch over to the Rancor cage itself again. I'm gonna put my paints together here momentarily. Probably paint the Stormtrooper test print that I have also. Find a container to put the styrofoam bits into. Where is a good container? Oh, you know what? I have this little Stonehenge thing. I'll build that later. Okay. I think this container will be fine for styrofoam bits for right now. It's housing my paints at the moment. Sort out the troopers. Actually, let me reorganize this into the bigger paint set. And I can use the smaller container that I've got for everything else. Okay. Almost ready here. Some nice fine paint brushes. Hopefully those will be nice. I probably have to use them on the Stormtrooper. Okay. This, from now on and henceforth, is going to be the Styrofoam box. Gotta do cleanup. Cleanup. Need a little broom or something for my desk. Okay, that's good, I guess. Not great, but it'll work. And where's the black? Because the black is what I'm basing this in. That needs to be black. I've got to get the other little bits, though, and glue them on. Actually, I might need to sand something. Okay, I've got these, and the doors. Alright, so there's the doors. Resprayed those last night. And the back part, this is an antenna. I need to probably get to sand this just a little bit. Where's my other sanding stick? Where did it go? Where'd it go? Too much junk on my desk. Okay, I don't see my sanding stick. They're right next to each other. Oh, I moved them, because... Yep, right. Where'd it go? I see it. Alright. So let's give this guy a quick sand, because... Got some bits and bobs on the antenna that I need to kind of clean up. So the antenna goes, like, right there. Once it's all said and done. This is camera better. There we go, right there. And then these go on the back up here. I have to get super glue, though. I've got to super glue this. So let's see. I have any toothpicks? I don't have toothpicks. There's my super glue. I don't know if it's any good. And I need a little... yes, I do. I have my little gluing cardboard section here. Trooper out of the way again. So I'm probably gonna glue this on, give this a black base coat, and then call it a day, and I'll set up another stream for tomorrow, since we got tomorrow off. Okay. Alright. So, we've got the gel here. This is going to be a bit tricky. Oh, that's weird. That was my... trying to make drool for the Rancor, but it didn't come out as I expected it to. Okay, question is which way around? Here with my glasses. It's like that's gonna be this guy right here, like this. Where's the other one? Right here. Let's take a look at him. Should I use my right hand? Okay. There's that. Put another dab of glue on it when I get a second. Yikes, that moved. See, these are supposed to be lined up, so I've got to really pay attention to what I'm doing here. And then this is supposed to go on here like this. And then this goes on the back pretty much dead center like that. So we'll glue this piece on next. I'm just gonna crap, my hands are shaking and the glue is moving. Just make sure it's straight. Let's just put some glue here and here. Can I put more glue on the ends? I'm getting too big of globs on this thing. I just need little dabs. This is moving. I don't know how long this glue takes to set. Now my fingers are probably glued together. Well, I could have some broken pipe too. That could be an option. There we go. That's better. And then this goes right underneath like that, but straight. So that's going to take some time to glue, I think. So it's still moving. Wonder if I can grab. Is this working? And it looks like it's probably all gooped up too. I think if somebody makes a super glue nozzle that doesn't ever clog, they'll be a billionaire. Yeah, it's all clogged. Okay. Just straighten that just a touch. It is a little off here. Getting worse. Okay. I think that's good enough so that I can just put this on top and let it glue. I probably should actually just let it glue rather than try and start painting this. I guess I can paint the doors, but I don't know about that. Do I want to do that right now? Yeah, let's see, okay. Alright, put some super glue on the back side here. Oh. I didn't paint the back side of this. That's probably a good thing that I didn't. And I just got super glue on the front. How did I get super glue on the front? From my fingers. Okay. Take a dollop of super glue. Probably not gonna glue because it's on the paint rather than the plastic. Okay, I think I've gotta let that sit. Let's close this up. So I've got that closed up, that's clear. That looks pretty much dead center. I don't want to tilt it too much. This is kind of off kilter, but it's gonna have to do. Again, can put some rust blobs and all kinds of things on it if I want to. So I'm gonna paint the doors black, I think. No, I need to not do that. I want to do the whole thing at once. So that'll be tomorrow's stream. I'm going to do the painting of this tomorrow, paint it black, kind of figure out where I want to go with that, and then probably pick up with sealing the styrofoam. And that'll give me time to check on some techniques and stuff that I might want to use for that. So, all right. It's been a pretty good stream, I think. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. And I'll be posting some of this stuff to my Instagram. Probably the... Yeah, the sanding bit, maybe, I don't know. We'll see what happens. But I'm going to stop for now, and I'll see you guys later. Thanks.